himself, Mr. Akshay Lakshman, who's been one of the main cast in the movie Memoir of Vicky Mothie, the South African movie that has been showcased here tonight on the shores of Mumbai, India. Akshay, well done on your superb appearance.
Thank you.
How did it feel to be part of a South African movie?
Well, for me to be part of any movie, this was the first time. Okay. And am I allowed to tell you?
Yes, go for it.
A short note of how this happened. It's actually very funny. As you all know, my profession is of a mentalist. I perform, you know, magic shows in a way. And Pinky Mothie herself was in my audience. And I was performing in South Africa on a cruise ship called MSC. And generally, people come up to me after those shows and they say, you're fantastic, you're good, this and that. She comes up to me and she says, hey, they're wasting your talent, you know that? And I don't understand, what does that mean? She said, you know, we are making a movie, I'll give you a role. And see, people come and they go. They tell you different things. They say, we'll make you do this, we'll make you do that, we'll send you to Jupiter, nothing happens. But actually, a year later, I got a call that, you know, we are coming to Mumbai and we'd like to meet, and here's the script and here's your role, you are Danny, and that's how it just happened.
Oh, wow.
It's a magic in itself.
Wow, so taken with trained eyes of Pinky Mothie, the veteran of South Africa, she meets you across the world
on a cruise ship.
And she's still looking with trained eyes and she selected you for the movie.
Exactly.
Well done. How did it feel for you being South Africa, because most of your shoots was done in South Africa.
Yes.
How did you feel to be part of the team in South Africa?
What I love the most about the team in South Africa, not being, rude towards Bollywood or anything like that, but since this is, you know, like one of the biggest industries in the world, the film industry in India, a lot of people have that in their heads. When you're working with them, you can feel the attitude. What I loved about working in South Africa is that everybody was just dedicated. We want to make this film. We want to make it the best. We want to give it like our excellent effort. No one had anything in their brains. Like, no one was prejudiced about anything. There was no sense of, you know, pseudo pride or anything like that. That's something that I love. In fact, from the Mothie family themselves, look at you. I mean, you're from the family, and I have never worked with a more down-to-earth family.
Thank you.
I think it was all because Amit Chheda gave me the freedom to, you know, to tweak the lines a little bit, to improvise here and there. He would be busy in his shoot. He would be shooting a scene, and I would just, you know, barge in between, and I would say, you know, I'm reading my lines. I think I want to change it to this. I want to change it to that. He would never say, don't come now, come later. He would say, okay, what is it, tell me. And then he'll hear me out, and then he'll either say, no, don't do this, or he will say, good improvisation. For most of it, in fact, such a humble guy. Here in the industry, we see that people do a lot of hard work, they don't get credit for it. Here, I did so much improvisation that Mr. Chheda actually gave me a credit in the end credits of additional dialogues.
Oh, wow.
So you can see the genuineness of a man, no insecurity at all, wants the actors to give their best, and he pulls it out of them.
Good, fantastic. What would you like to say to all the audiences, not only just South Africa, but abroad as well, because the movie will be worldwide screened?
Right. To the people watching it all across the world, this is a subject which will touch everyone's hearts. Because everybody has a vision, okay? Everyone has a vision in their life. And a lot of people just let go of that vision. They give up. I mean, what is the most justified reason to give something up? You know, if someone wanted to do something, they die. But, you know, when the legacy lives on, the show goes on, that's when a vision truly becomes a reality. So vision doesn't die. Only your hope dies, so you do not like to go off your hope. That's the whole point of the movie.
One last question.
Yes.
Okay. This was a movie that you did for the very first time.
Yes.
And it was a biopic movie of someone and a woman of stature, cultural heritage, and a veteran in South Africa.
Right.
And you spent many months with her during the course of the movie.
Exactly.
What can you say personally on the interaction with her and the family?
My interaction with Pinky, first of all, is that I never felt an age gap. and never felt any age gap. Pinky Mothie is a person I can sit and have coffees with her for hours, and I know I won't get bored. Okay, because there's a lot. She is, I don't know, she's just left aging to the body. The mind is, she could be more youthful than the youth themselves at times. Okay, that's Pinky Mothie for you. And I think that's what kept, she was the engine of this entire family and the film. Speaking of the family, I'm missing Rajiv right now a lot.
Yes, because
Rajiv became, I met Rajiv once in Mumbai before the shoot. And we became friends, we jed. But during the course of the film, he not only became like a best friend, became like a brother. We connected on a different level altogether. I think Rajiv, in one word, is a motivator. Okay? Even if I'm low, anybody's low, he would go and tell that person, you know, the reality of the situation is like, you need to give your best. So that's
Rajiv.
Yeah, that's Rajiv for you, okay? Lena, I tried hitting on her.
Carry on.
I failed miserably. No, but Lena, you know, she is a very sharp person. That's what I loved about her always. And, you know, I'm being conscious right now. We haven't had a lot of interaction though, but still, whatever it was always really positive. And I think we spoke a lot about business, and that's another love interest of mine, business side of it. Yeah, the one person I need to thank genuinely is Veena over here. Because Veena, as Pinky says, has been my marketing manager for this movie. According to Pinky's Confessions of Pinky Mothie, that's the sequel. That's where she says that, you know, hey, Veena was always, you know, behind the fact that you should have Akshay in the movie, let him play Danny, you know, something like that. So that's the Mothie family for me. Sara, not much of an interaction, but very sweet girl, very sweet person.
Thank you so much.